Hi there and welcome to the Let's Play of Hex Heresy of the Wizard. I'm Byron and this game has been sitting on my shelf since 1997. I tried it out back then, but I found it to be quite underwhelming and I've played other games ever since. But recently I watched Lana Ray play this game a bit. He didn't really like it a lot. But I was somehow fascinated and I started to play it myself, and after, I don't know, maybe 10 or 5 to 10 hours, the game doesn't really keep track how long you play it, I thought, hey, maybe I should let's play this. If I'm playing this anyway, I might as well record it, right? But I gotta give you a fair warning, I've never played this game, so I'm not sure whether I'm able to finish this. But nevertheless, it should be a fun experience. At least as long as the experience lasts. What else can I tell you? This seems to be some sort of remake of another game. A game called Blood Witch. In Blood Witch you move around like an Eye of the Beholder. You move in steps. And you turn in, you know, in 90 degree angles. But in Hex you move around freely like in Ultima Underworld. And like, for instance, in Ultima 7, you can't really control your characters in combat. You can only enter combat mode and then chaos ensues and then you win or you lose. And your characters get hungry all the time, so this is also like in Ultima 7. You can manually cast spells though. There's a backstory in the manual, but it's quite lengthy and not very well written, so I don't want to read it. I will just try to summarize it for you, so that you know what this game is all about. So this game takes place in some sort of a fantasy realm. So there are like, there's magic, and there are four gods. The god of chaos, the god of night, some kind of dragon god, and who's the fourth god? Chaos, night, Earth. Earth is the fourth god. And each god governs a certain school of magic. So if you're a wizard, a spellcaster, you pay homage and pay tribute to one of those gods, and those gods will amplify your magic in some kind of way. And this is how magic works. And through magic they also have a positive influence on the realm as a whole. But there was one mage, there's always one guy who doesn't want to belong, right? And he thought he was above paying homage and tribute to gods, so he sort of combined magic from the fringes of the existing schools of magic, and the results were quite unpredictable, but they also made him quite powerful. So he was able to cast magic without a support from the gods. But as he saw how powerful he got, he wanted, well, it got to his head, and he started harassing the populace of the realm and tried, you know, to make them pay tribute to him. And yeah, he harassed them by magical means, and the other wizards had to counter his evil spells with their own spells to minimize the harmful effects on the population. And this went on for a while apparently, and although this rogue mage was stronger than any individual mage, he was not stronger as all as the god-abiding wizards combined. And he prepared for a big battle, then he used some sort of divination spell to figure out how the battle would end, and he found out that he would probably lose this battle. He didn't like that news. And then he prepared another spell to take the gods out of the equation, if you want. He wanted to entrap each god in within a magical artifact. And the gods, of course, underestimated him. He was a mere mortal and all, so didn't want, you know, intervene directly, and in the end he used the spell and actually entrapped those gods in those four artifacts, and each artifact he hid in a dungeon, in a separate dungeon that was densely populated with monsters, and I thought the artifacts would be safe there. And now that the gods are gone, The other mages are less powerful, and their positive effect on the realm is gone too, so this rogue mage will now probably rule the realm. But the rest of the people figured out that if you would somehow bring those four artifacts in which the gods are imprisoned out of their dungeons and bring them together, then the gods would be freed, and I guess the evil mage could be beaten. So, and like it's always the case, they send out a party to do it, and you're controlling that party. So that pretty much is the backstory. What else did I say? That the game, well, the game actually is quite similar to a Blood Witch, not in the way the engine works, but apparently the levels are the same, the backstory is the same, the player characters are the same, the puzzles are the same. So if you played Blood Witch, you should have an easier time playing Hex because you know most of the answers to the puzzles. But I have never played Blood Witch, so I have no benefit there. Okay, there's also an introduction in the here that you can watch, but it's quite short and it doesn't really go into detail, and that's why I summarized the backstory for you. That was the dragon god that was imprisoned there. Okay, so this is our quest. Let's start the new game. Okay, you cannot create characters, you get to pick existing ones. So you have like four warriors here. You have four wizards. You have four rangers. And you have four assassins. And as you can see, each character belongs to a school. He is the Earth Warrior, Chaos Warrior, Dragon Warrior, Night Warrior. So as I like to have diversity in my party, I will pick one character of each class and I will pick one character of each school of magic. You have to keep in mind though that you only learn new spells when you level up. The wizard learns a new spell at every level up. The assassin, the ranger learns a new spell at every second level up. The assassin learns a new spell at every third level up. And the fighter, the warrior, learns a new spell at every fourth level up. So you can assume that the warrior will have trouble learning all spells of his school. Each school has 8 spells. The wizard will have all spells of his school once he reaches the 7th level, because he already starts with 2 spells. And then he can also learn spells of other schools. So even if you are a Night Warrior, you can also learn Chaos spells, or Dragon spells, or Earth spells. But I will try to keep them in their school of magic for as long as I can, to make it more easy for me, so that I don't accidentally overlook a spell or something. So I want an Earth Wizard, because he has a healing spell that you need in the beginning. then I want a Chaos Ranger. Because he gets a new spell every second level, and there are a lot of interesting Chaos spells that I would want. So, what else? Then we have an Assassin. I probably want a Dragon Assassin. He gets a new spell every third level. That means we will have to wait till level 3 till we get the Torch spell. Oh, well, okay, can't be helped. And that means we still need a Warrior. You go over here, please. And that would be the Knight Warrior. Okay. So, we have a Knight character. We have a Chaos character. We have a Dragon character. And we have an Elf character. We're good. Okay, so let's save. Oh yeah, I can show you how far I've gotten. This is how far I've gotten in the game. I obviously used other characters here. That is a warrior. I don't know what kind of warrior he is. Although I think I've written that down. This is a Chaos Warrior. They are hungry, but that doesn't have to worry us right now. So they all have 45,000 experience points. We also have a Ranger, a Dragon Ranger. We have a Knight Assassin here, and the Elf Wizard. But yeah, let's start with. Oh yeah, where are we? So as you can see, the game has a nice auto map. I'm already in the Tower of Grislam on my way down. I've already explored the 7th and the 8th level, and I'm going down now till I reach level 5, and then I'm out. And I actually got the first important item that is here, the Eye of Grislam. I guess the Earth. I guess it's the Earth God is trapped in there. So I'm maybe like a fourth of the game that I have completed, maybe. Who knows? Anyway. So you move around freely here. And if you hit R, the game creates a RAM save that you can easily load by clicking here. You have to keep in mind though that if you like load a game here, this also creates a new RAM save, a new RAM restore. If I would move now and click on that, I would end up where I loaded the game. So anyway, you have characters. We have an inventory, this is a Knight Ring, I don't know what that does. This looks like a face spell. Okay. Everyone has something to eat. Our warrior has a long sword. The ranger has a short sword. We also have common keys. Yeah, this is a short sword. What is that? Scroll of Wormwall. Okay. I don't think we need that. Okay, and here you have your character stats. Everyone is on level 1, has 1 experience point, and they are not hungry at all. They're full. Okay, what else? Ah, you can cast spells. Here, this is your spellbook. So, Tarnak, that's him. Tarnak Withenbane has a confused spell. Borgoth Exildeath has a deflect spell. Arundel Lurkunath has a missile spell. And Zastaf Mantric has an armor spell and a healing spell. And see, I cast armor now. And now the spell, the cost of the spell go down to 3. If I cast it again, they go down to 2. And I cast it again, they go down to 1. So the more you use a spell, the more proficient you become with the spell. And yeah, your mana costs go down. So let's see, we are healing on 6. Now it goes down to 5. 5. See how the costs go up. If you want to cast a spell often in succession, your mana costs go up. And this has something to do with this bar here. You can think of that as a concentration bar. The higher your level of concentration is, the lower the mana costs of your spell will be. So it's better for your mage to wait till he is fully concentrated. And that will then lower the costs of mana. And here's your maximum mana amount that you have at the moment, see? And we're down to 1. And we have missile. So it's a good idea to train like this. Okay. And finally, confuse. Okay, we're good. So this is where we came in. The door will not budge. What else can I show you? This is how you activate combat mode. There's nothing to fight right now. We need a common key, okay. We have common keys. Only a bed will grant you rest, I know. This is how you level up. When you have, well, of course, you regenerate mana and hit points when you rest. But when you have enough experience to level up, you can then go to a bed and sleep. And in your dream, you will level up, and maybe the gods will grant you a oopsie spell. Okay, we get some money, and those eggs are also a food source. Don't worry about the food, we will eat this. A dagger and another torch. So yeah, well, of course, those two fighter characters, the warrior and the ranger, can use all the weapons, at least I think. The mage can only use a staff, and the thief, the assassin, can only use a dagger or a staff. But if a character turns his back to you, the assassin may get in a backstab attack, and that does a truckload of damage. I've seen like 120, 130. I need a silver key. I do not have a silver key. We may need some light. I need to buy a few torches till I reach level 3. then my mage here, the assassin, will get the torch spell. Need a crystal key. Don't I have a crystal key? Have I overlooked the key somewhere? Let's look again. Yes, there's something here, see? A silver key. Okay, let's buff. Deflect. Armor. No, I'm dead already. That may have been overkill. And there's a shop, Ye Shop, the best prices in town. Okay, so we can sell this dagger. We can sell this Scroll of Formwall. And we will buy common keys. A bunch. Should be enough, and we will also buy a bunch of torches. Goodbye. Ah, before their bones. Yeah, if you go in here, you get healed. And if you have dead characters, they get resurrected as well. But I don't want to die, because I want to keep my characters in sync when it comes to experience. Bye bye bye. Because I want them to level up at the same time. See? The assassin did a whopping 45 damage. The backstab attack. That is pretty amazing. Oopsie. Oopsie. Misclicked. So, and if you see, the warrior now has 71 hit gold points, but you can distribute them evenly, and everyone has 96. And apparently we're getting hungry. So let's eat something. Okay, we have common keys. You're dead. And we do get crossbow and another key, crystal key. And I think I may have overlooked a few arrows here. Yes, I have. And we get some more food. Okay, so we now can open this door here. Oh, there's someone behind the door. Let's save. And who's that? See? 39 experience points. That's not bad. Not experience points. Damage. That's not bad at all. Oh wait, what's that? Leather. You don't have any equipment. You have leather. You have nothing. You have nothing. You have leather too now. I can't hit you over that distance, but we can, for instance, teleport in here and get ourselves a longsword. Cool. So let's choose the red shield. See, backstabbing is good. Okay, I need a gold key. I don't have a gold key. That was the red shield. Let's use the red dragon thingy. That already? Okay. So we happen to have a shield as well, a leather shield. Okay, what do we need here? A crystal key. I do not have a crystal key. Let's use the black teleporter. Oh, hi. Okay, we may need to heal. Ah, a gold key, how nice. Actually, I don't think we need that. We could sell that. Ooh, another shield, how nice. We need a silver key here, we have a gold key. That's not it. It's the other red. Gold key, okay. Nobody behind us? You get okay, a few more arrows, I mean. And a potion, a hedgehog venom. I think hedgehog venom gives you a hit points back. Let's check. Yep, gives you hit points back. Nothing else lying around here? No. Ooh, what's that? More armor. Okay. And another torch. That is much appreciated. Did you see that? Very good. And as you can see, the torch is burning out, burning down. not too nice. But here we do get another key. No, I didn't want to cast a spell. So we have another shield. See, AC plus 5, AC plus 6, AC plus 7, AC plus 6. The lower your armor class is, the better. It's pretty much like in AD&D. Okay, and if you want to get out, you take this death exit here, and this leads you back to the shop. Where you can actually sell stuff. For instance, I don't need this short sword. And I don't need this night ring. Okay. So I'm not buying anything else here at the moment, because I need my money to level up. Once I have to learn a spell, once I have enough experience to level up. I think 2000 is the amount you want to have. And we have, what kind of key do we have? The silver key. So it probably was this here? Nope, it's the other red. No. Must be black then. Exactly. You can rest here if you want to. Oh, what's that? Boots. I take your boots. Shit. Maybe I should buff. Aha! Victory! Let's not open that yet. Need a sun key. And we have gotten more common keys. Oopsie. Are we hungry? No, we're fat. This door will not budge. Okay. Oh, there's another guy in there. Do we need a buff? Ah, wrong button. Okay. Ah, I think 2,000 is enough for a rest. Let's take a look at the chart. Yeah. Okay, no, I'm not bothering with you yet. And not with you. Where was the nearest bed? Ah, here. Okay, so I think we will take this down. And save. Get our first level up. Sustab may learn a new spell. Which lord will you study? So you can choose Earth, Chaos, Dragon, or Knight. But since he is an Earth wizard, I'm choosing Earth. And I won't levitate. This spell shall cost you a sacrifice of 300 gold. This is a bunch. And the others gain a level 2. And Borgarth may learn a new spell. Let's check who Borgarth was. I think Borgarth was Chaos. Chaos Ranger, yeah, so this is Chaos here. Xtlaltic, Master of Chaos, offers Terror Anti-Mage. Let's pick Anti-Mage. This spell shall cost you 300 gold. Yeah, do that. There goes the money. And that's it. So, let's see, we're now level 2. And we have new spells. Deflect and Anti-Mage. As well as Levitate. So you might as want to level them up a bit. But I will end this video here. And we will continue on the next one. So, thank you very much for watching, and see you soon. Bye.